While browsing websites, you may come across a design feature where content is displayed appealingly, sliding horizontally or vertically within a specific area. This element is commonly known as a card slider. In this tutorial, we will create a visually pleasing and fully responsive card slider to showcase the recent victory of the Indian cricket team. We will include custom navigation buttons to make it easy to move between content. Additionally, we will add pagination functionality to give users a clear visual indication of their position within the slider. In the mobile view of our slider, only one slide will be visible at a time. The next and previous buttons, as well as pagination, will work consistently across different screen sizes. This layout and functionality can be customized to adapt to various screen sizes. First, we need to set the title tag in our index.html file. To create an interactive slider, we will use Swiper.js. Swiper.js is easy to use and library agnostic, which means it doesn't require an additional library like jQuery, making the slider much faster. First, we will integrate Swiper.js into our project by adding its CDN link for CSS inside the head tag. Similarly, for the swiper-bundle.min.js, we will add the link before the closing body tag. Now that we have imported Swiper.js into our project, let's create a style.css file in the root directory and link it inside the head tag. Likewise, let's create a script.js file in the root directory and link it before the closing body tag. I've already added the images that I'll be using for the slider content. If you prefer, you can use your images, or you can find the link for the image in the description. Now that we have completed the initial setup, we can proceed with HTML. First, let's create a section tag with an ID of cards. Within this section, we will create a div with the class wrapper to enclose all the elements for our slider. Following this, we will create a title using the h2 tag. To integrate the slider, we need to start by setting up the Swiper HTML layout. We will need to copy and paste the Swiper layout into our HTML. After the div element with the class Swiper, we will create another div with the class card slider. We will later initialize the Swiper using this class. We will then proceed to initialize Swiper.js by copying the initialization code. Initially, we will update the class name to card slider. Swiper.js provides a range of useful parameters. We will start by removing the direction parameter and adding the slides preview parameter to determine the number of slides displayed by default. Additionally, we will incorporate the space between parameter to create space between the slides. Now we have initialized Swiper.js with some parameters. What if we need to show more slides according to the screen size? For this, Swiper.js comes with a parameter named breakpoint, which allows us to set different parameters for different screen sizes. First, let's target screen sizes greater than 576 pixels. We will set slides per view to 2 and remove the space between parameter. Similarly, we will now target our slider when the screen size is greater than 768 pixels. For this, we will set slides per view to 3 and space between to 30. Once we have finished setting up Swiper.js, we can start adding content for our slides. All content should be wrapped in an element with the class SwiperSlide. Let's begin by creating our first card slide. We'll start by creating a div with the class CardContent. Inside this div, we'll add an image followed by a div with the class card title containing an h4 tag for the title and a p tag for the player with the player role. For the next slide, we can simply duplicate the card content div and update the content such as the image and title. We can repeat this process for the other slides as well. To add more slides, just duplicate the element with the class swiper slide and make the necessary changes. After finishing adding content to our slides, our next step is to customize the navigation buttons. We will change it into the navigation parameter, specifying the NextArrow btn class for the Nextel parameter and the PrevArrow btn class for the Prevel parameter. To implement the navigation button in our HTML file, after the closing of the swiper wrapper, we will create a div with the class arrow. Next, we will create a div with the class specified in the Prevel parameter. We also need to add an icon for our navigation button. To do this, we will use line icons, which is easy to use and offers a wide selection of icons. To integrate line icons, we will use its CDN link and place it under the head tag. For the previous icon, we will obtain the icon and place it within the div. Similarly, we will create a div with the class specified in the Nextel parameter. For the icon, we will find a suitable one and paste it within the div. Now, let's remove the default HTML layout for the navigation and scroll bar that we copied from the Swiper.js documentation. Once that's done, we can move on to customizing the pagination. To do this, we'll add a render bullet parameter for customizing pagination bullets. We can simply copy and paste the code, removing the index as it's not needed. Also for the pagination bullets, we will change its span tag to a list item and also set clickable to true. In the HTML file, we'll move the div element with the class swiper pagination inside the div with the class arrow. Then we'll change this div element to an unordered list. Now that we've finished working on our HTML and JavaScript, it's time to focus on CSS. Firstly, for the fonts, we'll be using Google Fonts, which offers a wide range of font options. For this project, we'll choose the Poppins font. We'll copy its embedded code and paste it inside our style.css file. First, let's apply some global styles using the universal selector and pseudo elements. We will set the box sizing to border box and also set the margin and padding to 0. These styles will help prevent unexpected margins, padding, and sizing issues. Moving on to the heading 2 elements, we will set its font size to 2.5 rem, color to white, and font weight to 600 for a semi-bold appearance. Similarly, for the heading 4 element, we will set the font size to 1.25 rem, color to white, and font weight to 600. For the paragraph element, we will simply add the color white. Next, we will select the image element and set its width to 100%. We will also set the object fit to cover and vertical align to middle. These rules for the image element will make it responsive, maintain its aspect ratio, and align nicely within its container. Moving on, we will select the body tag and assign the font family as Poppins to ensure that the Poppins font is applied to the entire web page. Additionally, we will set the background color to a dark shade. Next, we will target the div element with the class wrapper. We will set its maximum width to 1070 pixels and center this element horizontally using margin 0 auto. Likewise, we will give a padding of 0 on top and bottom, and 15px on the left and right. Likewise, we will target the section element with the ID of cards. we will set its margin top and margin bottom to 2rem and its margin left and margin right to 0. We will also set its minimum height to 100vh to ensure it takes up at least the full height of the viewport. Next, we will target the element with the class swiper and add a padding top of 30px. Now it's time to style our main content for the slides. We will start by setting its background color to a light, semi-transparent shade. Then we will set the cursor type to pointer and center align the text. We will also set the transition duration to 0.4 seconds and add a border with a 2px solid line in a semi-transparent white color. Finally, we'll add a padding of 3rem on the top and bottom. For the card content hover effect, we'll change the border color to a vibrant green when the user hovers over the card. Next, let's style the images within our card content. We'll set the border radius to 50% to give the images a circular shape and ensure a consistent size by setting the width to 150 pixels. Additionally, we'll center the images horizontally by setting the margin to 0 auto. Finally, we'll add a drop shadow using the filter property to add depth and a subtle glow to the image. Lastly, we'll style the title within our card content by adding a padding of 2rem to the top of the title. Now let's move on to styling the navigation and pagination elements. First, we will style the element with the class arrow, which contains both our navigation and pagination elements. We will set its display to flex and align items to the center so that the items are vertically centered within the container. Additionally, we will add a padding top of 20px. Next, let's style our previous and next arrow buttons. We will start by setting the Z index to 100. The border will be 1px solid vibrant green, and the color will also be vibrant green. The background color will be set to transparent. The font size will be 0.80rem. Text will be center aligned inside the buttons and the cursor type will be set to pointer. We will set the display property to block and the width and height of the buttons will be 2.75rem, creating square buttons. To vertically center the text within the buttons, we'll set the line height to 2.65rem. Likewise, let's add margin left to the next arrow button. This will create some space between the next and previous arrows. Next, we need to style the pagination bullets for our swiper component. We'll set the width to 60% and use display flex to arrange the pagination bullets in a horizontal line. The position will be set to static, and we'll center the pagination bullets within their container by setting the margin to 0 auto. Then, we'll style the individual pagination bullets using the .swiper-pagination-bullet class. We'll set the width to 100% and the height to 5px. To remove rounded corners, we'll set the border radius to 0. Finally, we'll set the background color to white. Next, we'll style the active pagination bullet using the .swiper-pagination-bullet-active class. We'll set the background image using a linear gradient to visually distinguish it from the inactive bullets. Lastly, let's add a hover effect to our pagination bullets in the swiper component. When the user hovers over a pagination bullet, we'll apply a background image using a linear gradient and set the opacity to 1 on hover. Additionally, we'll remove the default outline on hover using outline none. As we wrap up this tutorial, we've created a sleek card slider with HTML, CSS, and Swiper.js. This project was inspired by the recent victory of the Indian cricket team in the World Cup, and I believe that this card slider can be a tool for showcasing various items such as products, packages, and more. Lastly, I hope you've learned something from this tutorial. If you have any queries about this tutorial, please feel free to comment. I would be more than happy to help you. Also, for more tutorials like this, please like, share, and subscribe.